and the Dripple boy. Well, at least I do. He doesn't. He's just been
Super
out.
Drip.
He's just been out in the dressing room talking to Kim Wilde. He hasn't been here at all. I've been watching it all the way through, but there you were. Hey, weren't you?
You just give my secrets away.
Certainly.
Good, right.
She'll be here singing If I Can't Have You.
Well, she certainly.
There we go. First, we'll take a break.
Back after this. Now, Yvonne Elliman originally had a hit with Today's Pop video. It was taken from the film Saturday Night Fever, and Kim Wilde looks like having another hit with her 90s remix of this classic disco track.
Much to Mr. Holmes's delight, we'll be chatting to Kim Wilde in the studio after the news, but first, here she is with her If I Can't Have You. Talking to Kim Wilde just after the 8 o'clock news. Calm down, Holmes.
She does that very... Right, very good morning to you. It's 8:15. You're watching GMTV. Welcome back. Now, whether you're in your 20s, your 40s, your 50s, your 60s, you will probably know the music of the Wilde family. Marty Wilde was in the charts decades before his daughter Kim. We'll be talking to Kim about her latest single in just a moment, but first, a little walk down memory lane.
Each time we have a quarrel, it almost breaks my heart, 'cause I am so afraid that we will have to part. Each night I ask the stars up above, why must I be a teenager in love?
She is Kim Wilde, the most famous product of that marriage. It was nice to see your mum and dad there, a bit of nostalgia.
Yeah, it's really lovely. Didn't they look sweet?
They look very sweet. Who do you look like, your mum or your father?
I look like both of them, actually. A lot of people say I look like, a lot like my mum. They say I act a lot like my mum, and I look like my dad.
Is that good or bad?
It's very, very good.
Well, I said you looked very well in that video, Can't Have You. I remember that the first time around, Yvonne Elliman, Saturday Night Fever.
That's
what, 1978.
Yeah, I remember it the first time around. It was great, wasn't it?
Whatever happened to her?
I really don't know, actually. Good question.
Yeah.
I have to find out about that one.
Why that one? Why did you choose Can't Have You?
Well, actually, it was my sister-in-law's idea, Mandy, and I was sitting talking to my brother about some recordings we were doing, and she came in and she just said, what a great record. Have you ever thought of covering it? And we thought, no, we hadn't. What a great idea, Mand. Why don't you sort of go and become head of A&R at MCA Records? It would be a really good idea. So, great idea, Mandy. Well done.
Right. Well, I reckon that one will make it onto your Greatest Hits compilation. You must be putting one of those together.
Well, yeah. The Greatest Hits comes out in September, and this is a prelude to it, and then we're going to release another single in August. Yeah.
Are those going to be greatest hits of yours or greatest hits of those other people's that you particularly like that one?
They're all mine, yeah, apart from Hanging On, which we covered a number of years ago.
Tell you what, you said plenty of them. You've had 24 in 12 years. That's two a year. That's not a bad average.
Not bad, yeah. I think we're going to put 14 tracks on. And everything from Kids in America right through to recently, you know, You Came and stuff like that.
What would your favourite be?
Well, I love a lot of the stuff we did on the Clothes album, which had You Came, and I really loved Never Trust a Stranger. I had a lot of attitude and guitar, and it's really good fun to sing. So
Michael knows what these things mean because he's
attitude. I was just thinking, no, what does attitude mean? You mean it comes out and hits you?
It was just a really. I mean, I remember remember doing it on the Michael Jackson tour, and it was a real storm. And, you know, I was about to strut across the stage and. And get terribly melodramatic. And I love that about pop music. I love its melodrama and I love its theatre and I love its strength, you know. So I quite get into that.
You certainly look as though you do. What's Michael Jackson like to work with?
Well, he was great. I mean, he was a wonderful performer, obviously, to watch. I mean, he, you know, we weren't exactly down the bar having a jar at the end of the day, but I felt very grateful, really, to get that tour, because we were actually contracted to do 15 and ended up doing 35 shows with him. So, so it was a turning point for my career as well. You know, it really sort of shaped me up and basically really got my act together. I had to, you know, because I was performing
like
in front
I joined you, wasn't
thousands
it?
Of people.
Yeah,
it's a privilege.
The act.
Yeah.
The other thing that comes out and hits you.
When you're working with greatness.
When
with
greatness.
Yeah, with greatness.
It sort of rubs off.
It rubs off,
doesn't it, really?
The other thing that comes out and hits you from your pop videos are your lips.
Oh.
I mean, you're a great, I mean, if you don't mind me saying this, you're a great pouter.
Pouter, yeah.
Are you aware of your, the voluptuousness, if that's the right word, of your lips?
I have been made aware of them over the years, yeah, and it's strange because when I was at school, I hated my lips because everyone said that they were like Mick Jagger lips and that they were very large, and somehow I felt, yes, just like my feet and, you know, just like everything else about me, large. And it's just been over the years that I've been able to sort of actually think, actually, they're quite good, really.
And you're
make
a good
the most
pouter.
Of them.
Do you practice pouting?
I don't. I was born with this pout. It comes from my dad, actually. He pouted his way through the 50s, and I'm doing it through the 90s.
He practices pouting every morning for you. Come on, don't you?
Oh, don't talk about it.
Tell us, now, you've been very strict with your weight and so on. I mean, well, you can tell. I'd never thought of you as being particularly fat, but what, you lost about a stone and a half?
Yeah, I mean, actually, most of it had to do with exercise. I just didn't exercise at all during my 20s. And I think I was brought up in the generation that just missed that sort of keep fit. Mm. Yeah, I don't know what you're going to say about yourselves.
What? This is going to be close to the bone, isn't it?
Two Atlas figures,
I was just preempting what you were going to say, but anyway.
No.
I was sort of brought up in a generation that just missed that sort of keep fit sort of regime, and I kind of got in on the end of it. Started in my a few years ago, and it's really turned things around.
I know what you're talking about, because I remember you as a child when I was at school. You and I are the same era, same age and whatever. I'm going to talk to you about surviving and, you know, in this rat race and whatever. The other thing, if I was you, just a word of advice, I would go and get a tan. I mean, you're looking a wee bit...
bit pale?
Wee bit pale, a wee bit anemic, you know, so...
Yes, it's sad, isn't it?
It is, but there we go. Kim, stay with us this morning.
Sorry to break up these lovers.
After the break.
Claire Catford.
Can you not be interested in people? Can you not... human interest stories?
I feel like a gooseberry. Claire Catford, shift through our post bag. Stay with us.
North Wales, Sally and the gang out there. The stars are just falling out of the heavens here today. We've got David Essex and Kim Wilde back here in studio. And you two go back a bit. There's a family connection. How did you first meet?
Do you remember meeting me when I was a kid?
I don't. I should.
Do you remember you were in that film? Was it Stardust?
Stardust.
And I came on the set. My dad brought me on the set, and I remember he sort of brought David. That's when I was so overwhelmed.
Well, see, I mean, Stardust was a difficult character to play. That character in that, so I was probably slightly gaga. Mm. But your dad was in that. He played the manager of the band, and he was brilliant. He still is brilliant. Yeah. You're brilliant.
She is.
They're brilliant. Everything's brilliant.
We were just counting up your albums and singles. She's done a lot. I mean, seven albums in such a relatively short life. She's done well, hasn't she?
A mere really pittance. Well. I've done 17.
No, but you're 73, sort of... so...
No, from 1973.
Anyway, David, what are you doing here this morning?